Yeah, I think we're good to go. A very, very big welcome to the one and only Jazzy Jeff sitting to the right of me. Thank you for coming to the Boiler Room. And it's actually quite interesting. I was just telling you, this is actually the space where we initially started 4 years ago.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's a really big honor to have you here because, like, 4 years ago, we probably wouldn't expect it to be what it is right now.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Yeah, and I was just, you know, thinking, like, talking about the past and everything. Like, we know you as, you know, a really famous hip-hop DJ. Like, everyone knows you in regards to Will Smith and the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. But I've been told by so many other DJs that you are a proper, like, DJ's DJ, as they say. And, you know, and that it's just so much more to you than just being a mere hip-hop DJ. And I just wanted to touch upon the fact that I'm guessing growing up in the time that you were growing up, was there such a thing as a hip-hop DJ? Like, how did you grow up, you know, like, understanding what the whole thing was of DJing?
Well, I grew up just being a huge music fan. My dad was an MC for Count Basie, so we grew up with a lot of 78s, which is different than 33s and 45s, but a lot of 78 jazz records in the house. And then my older brothers were into the, you know, the Chick Careers and the Weather Reports, and then, of course, you know, the Earth, Wind & Fire, Marvin Gaye stuff. So being the youngest, I was kind of forced to listen to everything. And you just took it all in. You took every piece of it in. So when you kind of got to a point that growing up with hip-hop, you know, you had a base before hip-hop. You know, and especially, you know, the early days of hip-hop with DJs, you know, cutting breaks. And the breaks would be jazz records or funk records or whatever kind of records. But I kind of came up not as a hip-hop DJ because there weren't genre-specific DJs back then. They were just DJs. You know, you just played music. You didn't just play hip-hop. You know, and like I said earlier, I think a lot of it was because all of the different genres were fighting for legitimacy, you know, hoping to be around for a while. So that's what kind of made it very segregated, that people became hip-hop DJs or house DJs. But I think if you go back to the origin of any DJ who's been doing it for a while, it was never just one type of music.
Yeah, because that's interesting that you said that your dad was an MC for Count Basie, because I'm guessing a lot of people are thinking now, a rap MC?
No, so my dad was the traditional
MC for Count, like,
he was the traditional
kind of MC.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the world famous Count Basie. That's a traditional MC. He wasn't checking the mic and throw your hands in the air, waving like you just don't care.
And when you were growing up and listening to jazz all around the house, was that something that was already of interest to you, or was it just there, or like, were you going through your dad's records and trying to find out?
You know what? I think everybody kind of has this the same thing inside. People just don't really know how to harness it, which is when you hear certain music, it makes you feel a certain way. And it was just, I was just really intrigued. Like, why does this part of this record make me feel this way? Whether it be happy, whether it be sad. So I kind of think I started approaching music just for the emotional part of it. And then, you know, as I got older and started to understand exactly, you know, or kind of getting an understanding of what that is, then you kind of start looking for those records. Mm-hmm. But that was the things that kind of attracted me to jazz, you know, or whatever music, you know, for that matter. It was just more of the emotional. What does it make you feel? You know, what type of mood does it put you in?
Have you got, like, any examples or, like, a certain kind of record that you were listening to growing up, or just a certain sound?
You know what? The hard part for me is a lot of times I get asked, you know, pick some of the records that kind of influenced you. And it's weird because I give the exact same answer. Whenever someone ask me to do that, my brain goes completely blank because it's so much music in my brain that it's almost like it's unfair for me to try to pick one thing. No. You know, even as you know, even as an example, because you know, mine was so all over the place, from a Stevie Wonder to a Billy Cobham record to a Mahavishnu record to a Wes Montgomery record. Like, it wasn't genre specific. It was just kind of like, oh my God, that part in that record really kind of, you know, hits me. And that, you know, to me, that's the whole basis of sampling, you know, also, that it's just, you know, finding that part that you consider the magic and just looping it over and over again.
Yeah, because, like, what made you decide that you actually wanted to be a DJ and you know, start making it into a craft?
You know, I think it started just, you know, grabbing a box of 45s and being a guy that played at the basement house parties in your neighborhood. I don't think it was so much of being a DJ. I think it was just more so I wanted to be the guy that selected the tunes, and it just turned into that became my job in the neighborhood. And then, you know, I became intrigued about how to put these tunes together. Like, what, you know, you can play 10 records, but you can play them 100,000 different ways. And what way is seamless? What way takes people on some sort of a journey? And I think that's where the whole, I think I want to be a DJ started.
And were there any, like, DJs in the neighborhood that you were looking up to that inspired you?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the early DJs were more of the sound system guys, that they would bring these massive speakers out, and they would play, and you would just kind of listen to how they played, and you would, you know, I would listen, but I would also look at the impact that they had on the crowd and how, you know, he made people feel. And then, you know, then you want to get out there and try to do it yourself, and you realize that you can't do it if you have these little tiny speakers. Like, so you ended up having to put the whole package together. You have to get the sound system or either play on someone else's sound system. And a lot of times it only takes you to play in front of the right people the right time before everyone starts to know.
I'm guessing there were still, like, a lot of record stores around.
Millions.
Millions. So
I spent
it was easy.
My lunch money every day in high school. I had to admit that to my mom one day, that every dime that she
started
gave me.
Started to lose a lot of weight.
Yeah. I was really thin. Had a lot of records, though. Mm.
And when were you actually asked to do, like, your first paid gig? Like, how old were you?
Maybe 13, 14. It was a house party, and, you know, they needed some music, and you did it, and they gave you $20, and you just, you know, you were excited. As long as you could just keep buying records, you know, I didn't want to really take all my mom's money, you know, and I was getting a little hungry, so I figured out, you know, that if you can make $20 and, you know, and that's basically, you know, what it was. It definitely started out 100% for the love. You know, that you weren't even concerned about, you know, people paying you. You know, you would have probably paid somebody if they'd have let you play.
And like you were saying, you started out as a DJ. Is there any, like, a certain point that you would consider yourself, like, transitioning into being a hip hop DJ, or do you still consider yourself?
I'm a DJ. I'm a DJ. I'll always be a DJ. No matter, you know, I've never really been into the labels. I understand that society almost dictates that you have to put a label on things. But I was DJing, you know, before hip hop. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and I never stopped playing, you know, anything. I'm actually enjoying it more now than I ever have, because it's, you know, it seems like the cycle is going back around and people really want to hear a lot of different kind of stuff. So.
Yeah, because when we were talking earlier, there was a very interesting point you made about the whole iPod generation. Mm-hmm. Like, loads of people think the iPod was kind of, you know, make it more difficult for people to really understand what music was, because, you know.
I think the iPod helped it.
Yeah, that was an interesting point.
You know, it's just, you know, it's DJs used to always, you know, especially when iPods came out, they would always say, I'm not an iPod. But when you really sit and think about it, you know, the only people that put music in playlists are DJs or music people. Everybody else plays their iPod on random, which allows people to hear different types of music and different genres of music back to back, which made it a lot more accepting for people to go out in a club and hear a Mobb Deep record and then a Stevie Wonder record, because that's how it plays on their iPod. So I really think that the iPod and the way people listen to their music on the train, on a commute, you know, to work or at work, has really opened up people to listen to a lot of different types of music. I don't know anybody who likes just one type of music.
Yeah, no, very true. So I think, I don't know what time is it, but I think you are going to grace us pretty soon with doing a set for us, which okay. I'm really, really excited to see. So I don't know if you are ready to
get started. I'm always ready.
Okay. Fine. Well, let's do this.
He's eating somewhere. Yeah. It's all right. I don't need him.
Yeah. Is there anything you do need?
Nope.
Are you good to go?
You ready?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. I didn't like that. I'm gonna let you set me where I'm at and then I'm good.
Yes.
hits my window. When the rain hits my window, I take him me some Indo. Me and Timberland, we sang a dangle. We so tight that you get our styles tangled. Sway your do-si-do like you loco. Can we get pinky tonight like Coco? So-so, you wanna play with my yo-yo? I smoke my hydro on the D-Lo.
Now make that mother hammer sound like wobble, I'm stacking my paper. My wallet look like a Bible. I got girlies half naked. That look like the grotto. How your waist anorexic and then your ass is colossal. Like whoop, drop that air, make it boomerang. Take my belt off, bitch, I'm pooty tang. Tippy tow, tippy tay. You gon' get a tip today. That. You gon' get some
I walk in with my crew and I'm breaking their necks. I'm looking all good, I'm making her way. They pay me respect, they pay me in checks. And if she look good, she pay me in sex.
Do it.
Bounce that, it's the roundest. You the best, you deserve a crown, bitch. Right on that
dance. Benz a Bentley, my jeans are never empty, bitch.
Remembrance of ignorance or disgrace. Tell me who of them will come. isolation, exploitation, mutilation, mutation, miscreation, information to the evils of the world.
Stomach fulfilled, then they get hot, everyone starts to grill, and plot on a pot in hopes that it drops, and most of it spills. Why you think people that reach the top tumble down hills? It happened to Jack and it happened to Jill. The B side of success is a cycle I still keep in the back of my mind, so when I greet it with the glove, I beat it, moonwalk across it and kneel. I've been on my Tebow, and my Armstrong, I can Armstrong Debo. Adios, amigos. Honestly, your buck does can't tie my shoes. Don't care, don't care.
Song, I'ma call it track 10. Track 10.
Track 10 got your mind like bang. Talking about a 10, not an eye like bang. That wanna boom like the boom on a ring. Do you hear it back like a boom or a ring? Talking about a bang, but you know you gotta pop. Cause if it don't bang, it ain't never gonna pop. You see, I got a grand, so they call me Grandpa. You ain't got a grand, so they call you Grandma.
I go hard like things that go hard. Think of things that go hard. Up on your blog like that, post up, see that y'all like that.
I'ma drive in my car like groom. See me driving by in my car like groom. People wanna ride, but I ain't got room. They see me in my ride when I play that.
Boom.
Now blame that broom when I broom right past. But I got one too many brooms if you ask. But I got 122 on the dash, and I'm gonna run these 22s right past.
She gets mad when I don't say enough. She mad when I'm around. Mad I'm out of town. She telling me I ain't doing much. And my job is only barely a job. I'm like a child in my sandbox playing house.
Ouch.
Oblivious to a fault, content being ignored. I'm absent, a bore. Ain't no top of it all, obnoxious. And I don't bring the flowers anymore. I take time and never give it. Even when I ain't busy, I don't make enough to call. I make a living out of making a living. Because I never get upset. Listen to pay attention to mention her hair color, stare other women in lust, catching the glare from her. She wonders if I'm looking to make a trade. Is this part of the game? Thinking maybe I should just leave.
Power move.
How did you get here? Was you sent for me? Manhattan fly, Brooklyn bad, Maiden Stapleton. I wish I had some more treats, girl. Just a trick on ya. But this money ain't impressive, huh? Fly motherfucker from around the way. S-side till I die and I say it brave. Make money for my fam, fans out of enemies. And I'm smoother than a shot of Hennessy. Hennessy, 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 Hennessy. If I hit it then you go. Remember me, remember me, remember me.
Give the drummer some of this funky soul we got, yeah. You don't have to do no soloing, brother. Just keep what you got. Don't turn it loose, because it's a mother. When I count to four, I want everybody to lay out and let the drummer go. And when I count to four, I want you to come back in. It's in the collar. I got the holler. I said it's in my feet. Feels so sweet, it's in my shape. About to work me to death. It's in my shape. About to work me to death. It's in my shape. I walk the floor. I wanna walk the floor. One, two, three, four. Get it.
Thank you. promise that I know you very well. Your eyes never lie, even if they tell. Sweet lullabies that come with the smell of a dozen roses flipping down a green hill. You living in a world that come with plan B, cause plan A never relay a guarantee, and plan C never could say just what it was. And your plans only can pan around love. You love him, you love them, you love her. You love so much, you love what love hurts. You love red bottom and gold that say queen. You love handbag on the waist of your jean. You love French tip and trip that pay for. You love bank slip that tell you we pay for. You love a good hand whenever the car dealt. But what love got to do with it when you don't love yourself?
Everybody run, run, run. Yeah. Everybody scatter, scatter. Yeah. Some people lost some bread. Yeah. Someone nearly died. Yeah. Everybody run, run, run. Yeah. Everybody scatter, scatter. Yeah. Some people lost some bread. Yeah. Someone nearly died. Thank you.
tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. A tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off. A tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. Tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. Tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. A tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. Tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. A tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. A tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Tether him off, the sucker. Tether him off, we gonna tether him off, the mother sucker. Thank you.
making me funky now. No, here is a true tale. Why the ones that deal, all the ones that fail, yeah. You can move if you wanna move. What it prove? It's here like the groove. The problem is this. We gotta fix it. Check out the justice and how they run it. Selling, smelling, stiffing, riffing. And brothers trying to get swift in. Selling their own rubber home while some shrivel a bone like comatose walking around. Please don't confuse this with the sound. I'm talking about bass.
Welcome to the bank, where you deposit young money and you get cash money. I'm Tunchi the boss, and live from the vault, it's Bus a Bus.
Yeah. Swag mania, pop the ghost most. Carry the most beautiful bitches with us, happily toast. Keep the faculty close, gross when we give them a dose. Got MOD and leaning in each coast, scenery froze. Take notes, rock boats, diamonds that fit us. Chanel mention the winner who fucking with us. We coming to give them the shivers. Water we flow, spilling like rivers. Flooding the street, hoping niggas and swimmers move with gorillas. King Kong's Godzilla's when we roll up. Seat filling niggas, get up when
shit.
I show up.
Please don't throw up, hold your liquor, grow up. If you robbing niggas, we gon' show you how to blow up. Thank your lucky stars, that's the raps are. Tuck your shit in. My niggas bite like rent and to my chagrin. You never win, model thin, walking cracking your shin. She gives in every time that I spin. Square up, bow down to the kings of the hall. We way gone, talk shit while we ball. So what's cracking with y'all?
Native New Yorker, the slick talker, keep shit in order. Call a reporter, stepping like British walkers. Legendary swag fluent, see the influence, see how we do it. Get them into it steadily, got them stupid, so undisputed. Act full, back tool, till they pop off. Police crowd up the street, blocking them off, locking them off. Got these niggas wildin' while I signal my soldiers. Bossing it up, maintaining composure, stand on the sofa. 30 bottles, 20 waitresses, bring them over, see how we light them.
I made my debut in 86 with a melody and a president's mix. And I would stay on target and refuse to miss. And I still make hits for beats, parties, clubs, and cars and jeeps. My underground sound vibrates the streets. MCs wanna be when I play for kids.
One, two,
when they sweat
three,
with technique.
He's like King Midas, as I was told. Everything that he touched turned to gold. He's the greatest of the great. I get it straight, he's great. Claim fame because his name is known in every state. His name is Jay to see him play. We'll make you say, God damn, that DJ made my day. 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 God damn, that DJ made my day.
Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass go boom.
Remy Martin, some good ass.
Y'all ready for nine? Y'all ready for?
Yeah.
Word. Y'all ready for nine? Y'all ready for nine? Y'all ready for nine? Y'all ready for?
Yeah.
Word.
Yeah.
Word.
Yeah.
Word.
Got some Remy Martin, some good ass cigars. Check it out. Hey yo, late night candlelight fiend with diesel in his needle. Queensbridge leader, no equal. I come from the will of Ezekiel. To pop $1,000 bottles of scotch, smoke pot, and heal a people. Any rebuttal to what I utter, get box cutted. Counter many bad honeys, I slut, it's a high number. Name a nigga under the same sky that I'm under. Who gets money, remain fly, yeah, I wonder. Eyes flutter as love, but Nas pops up. Stars get starstruck, panties start dripping. The ways of Carlito, blaze, torpedo cigars. Drop rolls, hoes, drop clothes. Louis the 13th, freaks, women nice. Size I ride like cautious, thick, brown, and gorgeous. It ain't my fault. Semi-automatic weapons, I brought the world crazy. I'm rich and I'm girl crazy. Dick them, convince them all to praise me. The ideology's confusion. I lose them, fallace me. Who hate me? My gun off safety. Since a tunnel escape key, my jury in HD.
Let me see you do the.
Yes, Boiler Room, give it up for Jazzy Jeff. Thanks for coming down. Thanks for tuning in. It's a wrap. Oh, Scala. What time is your set?
One.
Okay, so do you want to repeat? 1 a.m. Scala, London. He's going to do it all over again. Nice one. Well, thank you for coming down. Great set. Thank you.